Chrissie, who is our special guest host today, you've had a very bizarre dream about a colleague. Oh.
Yes, I have. I often have dreams about people I work with, John.
Oh.
And I had... I used to work with someone in radio and I had a very... What's the word to use?
Sexual.
Erotic
sexual.
Dream about
really?
Him.
Oh.
Yeah. Mm. And I wonder, you know, if dreams have anything to do with hormones or something, because I was pregnant at the time.
Who was this colleague?
It was Dicko. I worked with him on breakfast radio in Melbourne.
Really?
And I know I'm not the first one. I know I'm not the first one to have a dirty dream about Dicko, but he was my friend, so it was odd.
Wow. And was he good? Was he, like, was it a happy... Was he? Were you sweating happy sweat?
Yeah, the BO was good. Yeah.
Have you ever told him about this?
I don't know. I don't think so. That's not the sort of thing that you tell people, is it?
Well, you know what? He's here now.
Oh my god!
Hi.
Oh. I think you left your run a bit late, Chris.
Oh, how embarrassing!
I'm absolutely honoured and thrilled.
Have I? I've never told you that.
No, but I know how much action you get, so that's great.
Let me smell your armpit. Let me just... Oh, it's delicious.
We actually recorded your reaction as you heard the news for the first time, Dickie, to the dream. We're going to see that reaction and find out what it all means after this very short break. You're watching Studio 10. Don't go anywhere. Hey, before the break, Chrissie revealed that she has had a recurring sex dream about...
Wow, that is a very harsh way to put it.
Recurring?
It was once, actually.
Oh, well, we're going to talk it up. About Dicko, who she worked with. Mm-hmm. Now, what she didn't know was that Dicko was actually backstage listening. Mm-hmm. And he didn't know that Chrissie was about to talk about this dream, so let's have a look at his reaction.
All right, so there
okay,
you are.
Okay, so you, what were you saying at this point, Chrissie?
She said she had an erotic dream about the person she worked with.
Mm. Yeah, oh, look, it's dawning on him.
Yeah, we can tell just by his reaction.
You were shocked there.
Yeah.
And then I think, Sarah, you said, who was the person? And I said, it was Dicko.
Yeah, look at that.
Look at it.
No reaction whatsoever. I clearly think below the belt, yeah.
You can see the smile just gradually becoming more and more uncomfortable.
So you were like, hey.
Yeah. I was a bit bemused. I can't believe we used to wake up at 4 o'clock every morning for 3 years. You didn't tell me.
But did you ever have any similar dreams about Chrissie?
Well, she's an erotic
I'm being. A whole lot of women. Has anybody ever had a dirty dream about you? I mean, of course they have.
But Jackie O's confessed a few times.
Really? But, so that really is what the O stands for.
And anybody else?
Well, Carrie Bickmore said that I am an older man pass.
Oh,
wow.
I want to find
out. I don't know why, but...
What this all means, whether, you guys should run off and get a room together, I don't know. Let's bring back in our dream expert, Rose and Sarah. Rosa, what do you think? What do you make of Chrissie's dream? What's her subconscious trying to tell her?
I seem to remember I gave Jessica similar advice last time I was on.
Oh,
and what was that?
Yes. Okay. So it's basically, in a nutshell, it's about connection, that you have a great working relationship with that person, but that you also admire their qualities. Mm-hmm. There's something about Dicko that you really admire and the qualities that he has that you want to integrate those qualities into your
integrate.
Own life. Yeah. Oh, it's about...
Nice euphemism.
Yes.